Are you concerned about learning PLC programming? In this series of videos, we're going to learn how to program a PLC by some examples. I promise you'll learn some practical useful tips and tricks in every single video of this free course, that you can use them directly in your real-world projects. We start from the simplest examples, and step by step, we'll grow to the advanced levels. So, if you're looking to grow your PLC programming skills, make sure to go ahead and subscribe and click the notification bell so that you know instantly when we do a live broadcast or upload a video just like this one. In this video, we're going to create a project for this simple process and configure the required hardware for that in the Siemens TIA Portal version 15.1. A project in TIA Portal contains all the hardware, network, programming, and monitoring system information. So, without any more talking, let's jump right into the TIA Portal by double-clicking on its icon. After a few seconds, we see this window. From the Start menu, I obviously should choose the Create New Project. I name my new project as Water Pumping System and specify a location to save that. Then I click Create. Now, other submenus of the Start menu are enabled and you see them here as well. As next step, that is configuring the hardware, we can select either the Configure Device or the Write PLC Program submenu, as they both do pretty much the same thing. They both let us select the hardware and configure them before we start writing the PLC program. I prefer choosing the Configure Device submenu and then click on Add New Device to add my PLC CPU. In the Add New Device window, in addition to controllers or PLCs, you see also HMI and PC systems that we will talk about them in future videos. Now let's select our PLC CPU. Okay, I'm going to choose an S7-1500 series PLC CPU, so I expand its folder and I think this 1513-1PN CPU is enough for our process. When you click on each CPU, you see a technical description of that and its specific article number. Just remember that, if you are going to program an actual PLC in a plant, the process to configure the hardware requires some information beforehand. For example, you should exactly match the order number or article number of the hardware in TIA Portal with the exact order number of your existing actual hardware. Otherwise, you will face some unwanted errors and you may not connect to your PLC. Among these three CPUs, I choose the last one and click Add to continue. If you want to know how you should choose an appropriate CPU for your process and generally know how to deal with real-world project challenges and troubleshooting them, you can follow up our next videos. In this window, we have three tabs: Device View, Network View, and Topology View. What we deal with in this video is the Device View tab. As you see, the software automatically has added the appropriate rail for the PLC and mounted the PLC on that, something that does not happen in the older versions of Step 7, like version 5.6 or older. On the right-hand side of this window, there is the Hardware Catalog pane in which we can find the hardware modules we need and add them to our configuration. For instance, in this simulation example, we need only a digital input and a digital output card, as we have three inputs and just one output. So I expand the DI folder, and as you see, there are 16 and 32 input channel cards that we can choose among them. I prefer a 16-channel input card. When I click over each module, in this case the digital input card, it shows me on which slots I can add this module by illustrating some blue rectangles around them. And if I expand the slots, we see that I can add it anywhere after the CPU. As another example, if I select the power supply module, there is another option to place that, and it is right before the CPU in slot 0, which is a more common practice. I also need a digital output card, and I can find it under the DQ folder. I choose this 16-channel DO or DQ card and add it to slot number 3. I save the project and then compile it. For compiling the hardware, we should first select the rail and then the compile icon will be activated. I think now we're done with the hardware configuration and ready to program our PLC in the next video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues You can ask us your questions in the comments, and don't forget to suggest the subjects you want us to create. You can watch these great videos as well.